Hey funnel builders, Mike here from sellyourservice.co.uk. So one of the biggest things that a lot of funnel businesses struggle with is their identity of what it is that they bring to the market. And in this video, I want to demonstrate to you and show you what it is that you need to be able to say confidently to anyone who asks you the reason that you're in that marketplace in the first place. Like, why are you building funnels? So on an earlier video, we talked about your vision for a business, your vision for a future. And I think a lot of people kind of connected with that and our idea of being able to say, well, I personally want to have an income of $100,000. So therefore, my business needs to run at $200,000 and I want to help, you know, business, small businesses do this kind of thing. And I want to share as much as I can with the world, whatever that particular vision is to you. And it's a very personal thing, both for your business and yourself, obviously. It's a very personal thing for you to be able to kind of work out. But one of the things that a lot of people struggle with is their identity of what it is that they actually bring to the marketplace. And typically when we talk to a lot of funnel builders and they'll say, hey, I build funnels. You know, this is the kind of stuff that we get up to. This is the kind of stuff that we do. We build landing pages or sales pages or email marketing. The first question that a lot of their customers will think, maybe not ask, is, okay, but why you? What are you bringing to the marketplace? Because frankly, funnel builders, digital marketers, SEO guys, PPC, social media, all of that, they're a dime a dozen. Why you? And a lot of people might think that this is your USP. And I think USP is a bit of a kind of an overdone term, frankly, of what a lot of people think is a USP isn't a USP or a unique selling point, unique selling proposition. But instead, you should be able to say, why are you in the market? So why is Mike Killen in the marketplace? What is he bringing? And there's a few things that you have to be able to do or say that you can do. Otherwise, you've got no business being there. So one of the first points is, what is it that you do differently to everybody else in the space? What is it that you do differently to everybody else in the space? And for some of you, you might have a really clear niche and you say, well, we only work with LMS businesses. We only build funnels for LMS businesses, or we only build webinar funnels for co-working spaces. Whatever that might be, there might be a particular area that you focus in on. There might be a particular niche or market that you kind of work within your product categories. But it doesn't have to be that. If there's a particular part of your process that's different, you have to be able to say that and the reason why you're in the marketplace. It often helps if you can explain why that is worthwhile, like why does that matter? But when we say to a lot of funnel building agencies, and I'll say, okay, so why are you in the marketplace? What's different about you? And they really struggle. You've got to be able to differentiate that. And what it can be is do something better than everybody else, doing something different or doing something new that no one else has thought about. So your ability to say, I do this differently, that's critical to even being in the marketplace. If you can't say that you do something better or faster or easier or unique or new to the marketplace, then you've got absolutely no business being there. And the reality is that there are so many funnel builders out there trying to do everything and be everything to everyone and do all the different types of funnels for all the different types of markets, that unless you can say that you bring something differently to the marketplace, then you've got no business being there. You can't lean on things like, oh, we're friendlier, or we're lovely, or we give great customer service, or we're reasonably priced, because everybody says that. A really good way, I believe, of differentiating yourself in the marketplace is if you say something like, we only work with LMS-based businesses, or we only build webinar funnels for co-working spaces, or whatever it is. If you say that, would your competitors say the opposite? And if they wouldn't, then chances are what you're bringing to the market isn't that different. So a lot of businesses will say, oh, we give great customer service, and we're reasonably priced. Or would your competitors say the opposite? Would they say, we're not that friendly, we don't have great customer services, we're not really experts in our field, and we're not very reasonably priced? Of course they wouldn't. They wouldn't say the opposite. So therefore, whatever you're saying probably isn't that different to what everyone else is. So that's a really good litmus test to what it is that you're bringing in the marketplace. A nice way for you to be able to think about this is, what do you want to bring to the market? We can talk about what the market needs and what your audience wants and the particular problems they need to have solved, but I sometimes think it's slightly easier for us to think about it from a perspective of, what do we want to bring to the marketplace? What do you want to do that's different? What is it that you want to bring? For me, making those initial sales of email subscribers to like splinter products or first-time buys, I love that process there. is something I really enjoy. I might build a little sales funnel for that, or a webinar funnel, or a remarketing funnel. So that little specific section. Now, obviously, selling splinter products is not going to be suitable for garden centers or co-working spaces or furniture manufacturers, but it might be suitable for people like plug-in builders. It might be suitable for SaaS products. It might be suitable for information marketers or courses. And even then, I should probably narrow that down a little bit. But that's something that I like to do. I like to bring that to the marketplace, and it's important that I understand that that's something I want to do. And that, one, I'm willing to talk about day in, day out, and write content about and share and bring to, and talk to other people. Kind of like with Sell Your Service, when it comes to selling marketing funnels, I knew that that's what something I wanted to learn more about, so therefore, am I willing to share that with other people? And turns out I'm happy to talk about this day in, day out. All I do is talk about selling marketing funnels to your customers, selling marketing funnels to current customers, new customers, pitching marketing funnels, how to price a marketing funnel, how to write proposals for marketing funnels, all of this kind of stuff I bring day in, day out. And then, and maybe I've gone about this in the wrong way, is I thought, well, what kind of audience would reciprocate with that? What kind of audience wants that? Now, I understand the point of finding a hungry audience first, but sometimes I do believe it's really important that you have to think about, because we'll do that in another video. We'll talk about finding an audience, finding a market, finding a niche, really niching down and becoming specific with someone that you want to work with. But what is it that you bring to the marketplace? You have to be able to say, I do this differently, I do this better. A kind of a second question that you can ask if you're really struggling with this, is think about the entire process. Write out the entire process that one of your customers would go through. It doesn't necessarily even have to be with something that you would do. If you picked any generic marketing funnel builder or generic digital marketing business, what's the process that that customer would go on? So they'd make an inquiry, they'd send through a contact form, they'd probably have an initial call discovery session, then they'd get sent the proposal, they'd be pitched to, close it, send the deposit, design, development, launch, remarketing, all this kind of stuff, right? Writing out that process and ask yourself, what sucks about that entire process? What sucks about that part of the journey for my customers? So for businesses that want marketing funnels, what sucks to them about having to get involved with that? Now, it might be that they absolutely hate the idea of creating content from scratch, or they hate the idea of having to rebuild their website. And I know a lot of businesses, I personally believe that you can convert a website into a funnel. I actually think that's easier to do, or to set up a separate funnel on a subdomain rather than doing it from scratch. There's loads of part of that process and that journey that really suck for the customer. This is a bit of an iterative process, which means that, let's say I decide that I think, you know what, that part of the journey really sucks. So most businesses, when they launch and they just say, hey, their website's live. I'm like, well, I think it'd be quite cool if you had like a launch campaign for a product and you treated it in the same way as a sales campaign. And it meant that as soon as you launched a new website, you were generating revenue. So I think that part sucks and I'd like to change that. Let's say I then go back to my marketplace and I think, well, who has those kinds of problems? Where's the hungry audience there? And it might be that after I've mapped out that process and I've kind of narrowed down my market or my audience a bit, and I think, well, information businesses, course-based businesses, that those kind of really work with that, software-based businesses work with that kind of process. I might then flip that again and think, well, with a software business or an information product-based business in mind, I might write that process out again that they specifically might go through, and I'll think, what sucks about their journey? What do they not like about their journey? And what is it about the process of building a marketing funnel that they really struggle with? And I've just covered off like 1/10 of the entire journey. You might talk about remarketing. You might map out the entire remarketing process of some start to finish and think about, of all of those processes, of all of those individual components, what really sucks about each of those pieces. So first of all, we're thinking, what is it that we're bringing to the marketplace that's different? Why are we in the marketplace at all? Now, this can't be enough for you, it can't be enough for you to say, I really feel that business owners need to generate more revenue from their website. I'm in the marketplace because I feel that business owners should generate more revenue from their website. Again, would your competitors say the opposite? You might truly believe that. You might genuinely have a moral conviction inside you, which we'll come onto in another video, a moral conviction inside you on, like, business owners should generate more revenue from their website. Your job is to turbocharge your website, right, and start generating revenue through that website. But your competitors aren't going to say the opposite. Your competitors aren't going to say, well, we don't do that. So instead, you need to bring something that's definite, that's unique, and that frankly no one else wants to touch. Interestingly, when we said, I'm going to teach people how to sell marketing funnel, I'm a sales coach. We run a sales coaching business at Sell Your Service. And everyone was saying, oh man, that's way too niche. That's way too narrow. And interestingly, I'm actually thinking now, maybe I need to narrow down further. Maybe I need to become further down that line of how to sell and position marketing funnels and price marketing funnels, because I think it's too broad now. But originally people were like, oh, you should just do sales training. So now when I talk to other sales trainers and they say, you know, we help anyone, we help telco businesses. And I'm like, what is it you're bringing that's different to the market? I help one very specific type of business sell one very specific type of product. What is it you bring to the marketplace? And you'll see that the successful agencies, successful funnel agencies, they bring a very specific new thing to the market. They're very different. They bring something different. They do something better. And they can even prove it. You know, that would be a really good thing for you to do. You say, look, the average cost per click for cold traffic is whatever it is, you know, 20 cents. We can halve that. We can halve your cost per click. Now, I've talked about how cost per click's not that important, but it's just an example. So you have to be able to think of that. And if you want ideas on how to think of what it is that you bring to the market that's different or better, this is not your niche yet. This is just what you do that's different or better. And you might want to write out 5, 10, 15 things. You might want to write out a bunch of stuff that you bring to the marketplace. Another kind of really good way of getting into this is to write on one side what everything that you're good at, everything that you are like, you're quite competent at doing, and everything that you could charge for. Doesn't matter if you enjoy it, we'll come on to that in a minute. So everything that you can do, everything that you enjoy doing. So for me, it'd be like SEO, keyword research, building ad creatives, building sales pages, landing pages, writing email campaigns, setting up automation funnels, all those kinds of things. And in another column, write every single thing you enjoy doing. And again, it doesn't have to have any overlap. You could write apps, every single thing that you enjoy doing. So for me, again, it's writing sales letters, strategizing over marketing, kind of building out those marketing funnel plans. You want to then find an overlap. So wherever those overlaps are, is things you're good at and things you could charge for and the things that enjoy doing, that overlap there, that's a good indicator of something that you could bring to the marketplace. And you could look through those things, look at the processes within them, map out the entire process for those 5 or 10 things that overlap and think, what sucks about any piece of those? And just focus on one, just focus down on one piece and say, we're gonna change this part of it. We're gonna change just this part. Opt-in Monster just changed the opt-in form game. That's all they focused on. They could have been landing pages, they could have done conversion forms, contact forms, all of that. They decided not to. They just did the opt-in forms. And even then at the time, they were much, much more narrow than that. So to recap, you have to bring something different to the marketplace. If you're not, you've got no business being there, frankly. And you could be the world's greatest marketing funnel builder, but if you're not competent at saying that we do something differently, then absolutely no one's going to be interested in it. An easy way to find that, number two, an easy way to find that is by examining what sucks within a particular process. And to kind of discover those processes and to discover those things you want to work on, you've got your two lists, things you're good at and things you could charge for and things that you can things that you enjoy doing and where those overlaps are. Those are the processes that you want to check out. Thanks very much, guys, for watching the video. If you've got any questions about kind of discovering your market need or what it is that you're bringing to the value, let me know in the comments below. I'm really kind of enjoying doing these videos at the moment. Had a little bit of engagement and stuff, so it's good for me. And if you could like and share and subscribe and all that kind of shit, we'll crack on with that. In the meantime, guys, thanks very much. I'm Mike from sellyourservice.co.uk. Keep building those funnels.